If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture on GATE analog electronics series. So today we'll be solving two questions, 31 and 32. So with that, we'll discuss a little bit theory about JFET, MOSFET. Theory means very brief discussion, just the formula is which formula when to use. So this theory we'll discuss, then we'll solve 31 and 32. Okay, then let's try to solve this question. So just an intro to this formula, no theory discussions, so it will be easy for you. So you will understand where which formula to be used, otherwise you will get confused. One time I will be using one formula and another time I will be using in another formula. So I am not going to how this operates, just on the formula, basics formula. So if you take JFET, the JFET operates in saturation region. Generally we bias it so that it operates in saturation region. How we will know that it is in saturation region? Its gate, diode, source, these are these combination terminals, three terminals. So if your VGS is greater than your VP, that is pinch off voltage or VG off voltage, if it is greater than that, in case of N channel, I am saying this is for N channel. So if your VGS is greater than that, then your ID will come. Similarly, for P channel, reverse will happen. If VGS is less than that, then I will increase. If it is less than, then it is increase. If you go beyond that, then it will be in cutoff region. No current will flow through ID. Unlike your transformer gate was current was flowing, but here no gate is because it is voltage control device. You apply voltage across VGS and you get current. No current is flowing in the gate. That you have to be very clear with. And what is this current equation? This current equation is this one. So this is a very famous equation. In case of FET, we will be using this one ID. If it is in saturation region, then the formula of ID is this one. That depends on only VGS. These and these are always fixed quantity. It will be given. And maximum will be occur when VGS is 0. When it is at 0, then you see maximum will be IDSS. So this is for JFET. This is for N channel, this is for P channel. This you can remember. For N channel you remember, P will be just reverse of that one. So these are the common terms that you will find in all three, MOSFET, JFET, in everywhere. So these are known as transconductance. Transconductance means whatever voltage you are giving, correspondingly how much current you are getting. That is your transconductance. You are giving VGS because ultimately it is a switch. This switch is controlled by this voltage. If it is an ideal switch, then if you give little bit voltage above this, then it will be totally short circuit, all current will start full flowing through this. But here you can have a control over it. So if you change VGS, this current will change. So this is the transconductance. Drain resistance, what is the that is the internal terminal resistance of the transistor itself, field effect transistor, FET. What is the internal contact resistance of the drain? So RD. So if you see in small signal analysis, you will see that will come in parallel. Okay, that will be separate. We'll discuss that one. Just for now, you remember this one. VDS by IDS, that is your drain contact resistance. So that is it, internal characteristics. Amplification factor, what is amplification factor? Amplification factor is mu. What is how much VGS and you are getting and how much VDS in the output side voltage you are getting. So that is the amplification factor. Okay. Now, in MOSFET, if you come, there are two types of MOSFETs. Again, you will find one is depletion type, one is enhancement type. The depletion type is the same as your JFET. Whatever you learned for JFET till now, same this formula will be applicable here. This ID formula will be applicable here. It will work at saturation. When it will work at saturation, when VGS is greater than VP, the curve will be same like that. Your N channel here, it can cross this also. Same will be here for P channel also. The reverse one, I have not drawn here, this one. So these are depletion layer, which is exactly same your JFET. So if you remember this JFET formula, this you can apply in depletion layer MOSFET also. So you will be seeing that I will be using the depletion MOSFET form in the same JFET formula. Now if you come to enhancement type MOSFET, same depletion MOSFET, when it will be on, when VGS is greater than VP, then it will be on. In case of N channel, in case of P channel, when VGS is less than VP, then it will be on. That's it, on is same. You have to think when it is on. Enhancement type MOSFET, there are N channel, P channel, so let us discuss N channel first. If your VGS is less than VT, it will be in cutoff region. VT is the threshold voltage. So similarly, inverse one, same type of drawing you can think of. Here VGS is greater than VT, then it will be cutoff. If it more than that, then it is cutoff.
So you think that. So here VGS should be greater than VT for on. Here VGS should be less than VT for on. It until now it is same as your JFET and depletion MOSFET. Now what changes? If it is on, there are two different regions: triode region and saturation region. Triode region is a linear region. If you see this graph, this was the graph. This is VDS. For every if you increase VGS, your ID is increasing. You see, so there is a linear portion, this one, and there is saturation portion. This is known as saturation portion. This is known as triode region. Same in JFET and enhancement MOSFET also you will find, but there mainly we are discussing only about saturation region. But in MOSFET enhancement type, you will find these two separate regions. Triode region. Triode also there are separate part. One part, one is constantly linear. They say there's no need to go for in detail that much, that you can study in theory, but for numerical I think that's enough. So this is your triode region and this is saturation region. So for on you have two portion, when it is in triode region, when it is in saturation. Triode is also known as linear region. So when it will be your VDS, because you are increasing your VDS, once you make it on, next you increase VDS, it will start increasing. So if your VDS is below this one, then this is in triode region. Once you cross this one, then it reaches saturation region. So even if you increase VDS, there is no increase in ID. So you can see this one. So for saturation region, your VDS is greater than or equal to. Even if it is like equal to, then also it will reach at saturation. So this is the boundary point from linear to saturation region, the equal to one. Less than this, it will be in triode region. Greater than this, it will be in saturation region. And if it is in triode region, then this is the formula. You can see K is a constant, we will discuss here, it is written, and here we will be using this formula in case of saturation region. You can see, so in case of P channel, this is just opposite to this one. You can see VDS is greater than VG minus VT, then it is triode, but because the figure is just opposite now, and here VDS is less than this. And what is this K constant? That is known as, for P channel it is mu P cox W by L. These are dimensions of the some dimension of the MOSFET. I don't think that far details is required, but you have to remember. You just remember this one. We generally say mu cox W by L. This one we cox we say C O X C. O X is in the suffix, and for N channel it is mu. So I think that's all, and I want to discuss in the formulas so that when I apply formula, you don't get confused where I am using which formula. Okay, now if you come to question number 31, an N-channel JFET having a pinch of voltage VP is this much and transconductance of this much of 1 milli ampere per volt, when the applied gate to source voltage is minus 3 volts, its maximum transconductance they are asking. Now what is transconductance? Transconductance you have seen GM, that is your del ID or change in ID with respect to change in VGS. So this will come from the differentiating this one, the change of this with respect to VGS, because this is the formula for JFET. You remember the formula for JFET? JFET and depletion MOSFET, the formula remains same. So if you differentiate it with respect to VGS, what will happen? 2 IDSS 1 minus VGS by VP. Sorry, VP will be here only. 2 into X, and then differentiation of this one, it will come a minus VP. So I am putting that minus 1 by VP, because the constant will come here if you differentiate it. Okay. Now this is given, initially this is given, what is given? When the pinch of voltage is minus 5, then it is given 1 milli. So this is given 1 milli ampere, this is 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. And then VP is given how much? Minus 5, 1 minus, what is VGS? That is minus 3. What is VP? That is minus 5. If you do this one, I think you will find this minus, and there is a minus, this minus, this minus, this minus 1. If you do all these things, you will find IDSS, it is your 6.25 milliampere. Now they are asking maximum transconductance, it is GM. So what is maximum? GM max. If you see the expression of GM, this is the GM. When it is maximum, maximum occurs when VGS is at 0. We have seen the IDSS maximum, ID will occur when VGS is 0. When this is 0, because everything is constant, these are all constant, this depends on the what type of JFET you are using. So variable is here. If it is 0, then it reaches maximum. So for maximum, VGS is 0. So if you put it here, so it will be 2 into IDSS divided by, this is 0, so it's only VP. So this is 0, so 1 minus 0 is 1. So if you put is 2 into IDSS is 6.25 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by VP is minus 5. So ultimately you will get 2.5 in milliampere per volt. Obviously in milli because 10 to the minus 3. So that is your option C. Now if you come to question number 32, for a N-channel enhancement MOSFET, now it is N-channel enhancement MOSFET, in the figure the threshold voltage, so this you have to be very clear which MOSFET they are asking, and enhancement type MOSFET. The threshold voltage VT is 2. The drain current ID of the MOSFET is 4 ampere when a drain resistance of RD is equal to 1 kilo ohm. RD equal to 1 kilo ohm. If the value of RD is increased to 4, then the drain current ID will become. So, and again for MOSFET, enhancement MOSFET, we will always assume it is in saturation. And then we will check whether it is in saturation or not. Like transistor, we will always consider active case, then we will cross check whether it is correct or not. So, here also we will consider it is in saturation. So, for saturation, what was your ID? ID is equal to K into VGS minus VT whole square. You can see this one for enhancement MOSFET. So here given, see your ID is given 4 milliampere, 10 to the power minus 3, K you don't know. And this VGS, how much is, what is VGS? If that you have to calculate, because ID VT is given minus 2. So you can, if because this current ID is given 4 milliampere, so G is this one, G is this position and S is this. So what is the voltage across this? So if I come from this voltage, you can take a KVL along this path. Along this path you can take a KVL. So if I take a KVL along this path, what I will come first, because this is plus 10 means what I told you can think of a battery, this is connected like this, positive terminal is connected. So if you come from this side, you will first get minus, so minus 10, then plus ID into RD, then this is 0, this is 0, then plus VGS, that is equal to 0. So your VGS will be equal to 10 minus ID is how much, 4 milliampere, 4 into RD is 1 kilo. So 4 milli, 10 to the power minus 3, 1 kilo. This is 6. So you know 6. So once you know 6, you can find K. It is 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now once you know K, now what they are asking? Find the value of RD. You can now cross-check this one also. What will be VDS? You check VDS whether it is in saturation. The formula that I have used, that is correct or not. If you check your VDS, for saturation reason, VDS should be greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. What is VGS? VGS you got 6. What is VT? VT you got, VT they have given 2 volt. So you, what, and what is VGS? This is my this side, that is 4. This side. And what is VDS? From here to here, what is the voltage? DS. You can see DS and GS are same here. Because D and G are short. So whatever GS you will get, the same voltage DS you will get. So VDS is 6. Or you can think of 10 minus this drop will be VDS. So 6 is greater than 4, yes it is greater than 4, then this formula is okay, what I have used. Now the value of RD is increased to the, now they are asking D, ID. So ID will be equal to, this is again 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 4 K. And now VGS is how much? Again VGS you have to calculate, VT you know too. So what will be VGS? VGS will be RD. RD is how much? Now it is 4 into 10 to the power 3 multiplied by ID. That we don't know. Now you can calculate from here ID. Because here also ID, you can calculate. So if you solve it, you will find two values of ID, 2.84 milliampere and 1.4 milliampere. Now which one you have to take? Now you have to choose. Because I have used this formula, so it should be at saturation level. So if I calculate my VDS should be greater than VGS minus VT. So what is VGS minus VT? VGS is here. How much VGS I got? You have to calculate. What is VGS? So if you calculate your VGS, it is 10 minus ID into RD. So ID, RD is already 4 into 10 to the power 3. And if you calculate, suppose this one, 2.84 into 10 to the power minus 3. First one I have chosen. This one I have considering. So I am calculating VGS. If you calculate, it is minus 0.12. So first thing, it should be greater than VT. It is not greater than VT. So it will not be on also. Forget about saturation. For to make it on, VGS should be greater than VT. This was the first condition. And then in on, we have two conditions. One is triode, one is saturation. So this one will not be the answer, obviously. So you don't give 2.84 because both are given here. So 1.4 will be the answer, this one. So no need to check. You can check also with 1.4. If you check, you will find VGS is, you will find it is 4.4. So obviously, it is greater than VT. And your VDS will be also greater. VDS will be 4.4. It will be also 4.4 and it is 4.4 minus 2. So this is also satisfied. So it is saturation. So it is correct. So you start with saturation region and check either this condition along with this, this will come once this satisfies this. First it has to satisfy this. First it has to make it on, then you have to check whether it is in saturation or in triode, because in enhancement MOSFET you have two reason of.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.